We're sad.
I will show you how to make this industrial terrain in little under an hour. And if you keep up that pace, you can build a whole kill team table in under 12 hours. So that's a nice weekend build. I built half a table already. So let me show you how I built this model and one extra. Let's get it in.
Okay, so I'm starting with this little toy barn. I got at the Action for €2. Perfect scale. I always get my offcuts when I go to the home improvement store, saw to 30 by 30, so I have nice base to base things on. And this is an ideal fit for this little barn. I want my models who have 25 to 40 mil bases to easily walk or be able to walk around it. So that's what I'm measuring out now. Once I got my dimensions right, I'm just marking it so I know where to glue this thing down once it comes to that. Okay, so I got myself a little IKEA bobble, some more IKEA cabinet spacers, I think, and I got this this girder type thing off of a toy crane. I always buy 3 or 4 toy cranes when I see them discounted, so this was a perfect opportunity to grab me some industrial bits and to actually use them. So I'm basing this these cabinet spacers on top of the IKEA bobble flobble and just dry fitting. Got myself a little water tank. That's actually from the same set as the toy crane. Gave the little tractor that came with it to my son. And I stole the manure tank. And the manure tank is going on top. So there's some nice pins at the bottom. I'm going to use these for extra stability. I'm going to drill holes in the roof. So it's nice to measure how far they are apart. So I can drill holes in the roof for the glue to go in. And that is like sort of pinning it in place. It gives me extra structural integrity. I'm marking where I roughly want the tank to be. Marking down the drill holes. I'm using a nice fine liner to draw on the plastic, so because that really sticks. Like I feel that pencil and ballpoint and gel point, they don't really stay visible. So I'm expanding the holes I drilled with an X-Acto blade. Facilitates a better fit for the pegs. Now I'm putting some hot glue in there, as you can see. A couple of beads, not too much. And it fits on there like a charm. Always get rid of these stupid strings. I double tap it, just give it an extra shot of hot glue. And when I feel everything is dried, I apply some more hot glue to the base and I stick this down. Make sure to go all around it so it won't come loose after I add wash and paint to it. Just sealing it completely, pushing it in place. Double tap the edges. I do this along the entirety of the building. I'm only showing you one side though. So this IKEA, I don't know what it is. I think it's a hole cover. They're really cool. And you always get extra when you buy an IKEA kitchen. So sad to see them go to waste. So I use them in this build. And the toy crane also gets a helping of hot glue. I find the center, double tap it. Double tap it on all sides. Pow pow. Shmrah. Gang. Cabinet spacers. So these actually keep the cabinets off the walls. Just enough for the mounting rack to be placed on top. And here's just an extra greebly I found that could add a little bit of stability to the build because it was leaning off crooked to the right. I didn't want that. I had to make sure that it was flush, so I think this is called an angle ruler. Once I was happy, I marked it. Now I know where to glue these things. Yeah, hot glue, as always. One of my favorite tools, hot glue. So you find, you center it, and once you've centered it, you start pressing it down. And once you're happy, you lock it into place with a double tap of extra glue. If you go around the sides, that's extra sturdy. I don't recommend lifting these toys by the extremities, but you won't knock them over at least. So you see at the top, I added another cabinet spacer, and I added the innards of the trigger of a water gun, and now I'm adding some more greeblies, a little bit of sprue. And this was actually inspired by Eric's hobby workshop. I saw in one of his sci-fi builds that he was adding 5G antennas. You can't stop those things, they're everywhere. So I thought, well, let's bring some real world into my sci-fi gaming. Now I'm building this antenna out of a couple of pieces of sprue, and I clipped something off one of those curling, like, things that women use to curl their hair, like old ladies. I don't know what these are called, like permanent rollers or something. Hair rollers. Just cut a strip off, looks nice. Extra grooblies, Hot Wheels tracks, those little things you get to lock toy cars in into the cardboard. Shut the doors, remove some of those nasty strings. Yeah, this will help a lot during painting. Okay, so I found some anti-slip mat, and it's corrugated, and I love how durable it is. I think it's better when painting than corrugated cardboard, of course, but that's just me. If you like cardboard, use cardboard. So I put these patches on the roof to make it look like it was mended. I put some nice tie rips for extra details on the crane. Just some nice greeblies to catch the washes. This makes it look more visually interesting once it's painted. I'm basically breaking up flat surfaces. I found this domino piece. And, that's some mini stack. Some like plastic pixels you can put on a rack. But I flip them upside down and they have these interesting little legs. Once you paint this, it's unrecognizable. Add another tie rip because they have a nice detail on the inside. Those little ribbles. Once I'm happy, I glue it down. I use power glue, super glue, and I cut it so it looks symmetrical to the other side. Yeah. Okay, so now I'm sealing the MDF. I'm using a mixture of acrylic black paint, white PVA, and varnish. I do this so the MDF doesn't drink all the paint from the spray can. If you ever sprayed MDF, you know how fucking ugly it looks. If you go over it with a spray can once, it turns all patchy. So once I had that dry, I selected two spray cans. I went for a matte black and a very simple silver. And then you can let it dry or you can just black bomb the fuck out of it, which I'm doing right now. So I'm hitting all the toys, I'm hitting the wood. Covering everything in black paint right now. I have my windows open, so it's okay. I had a nice Corona mask on my face, beautiful. I even protected one hand. The other hand got entirely dirty. That's beside the point. Okay, so once I was happy with the black paint, I whipped out my silver and I started dusting it. Just short puffs. And if you think something is too silver, just dust it again with a little bit of black. It's not that hard. So from Hobby Luck, I got this nice copper and this nice orange. Very cheap paints, very high pigment. And what I did is I did a little bit of a dry brush. Nothing too extravagant. Just wanted to have a copper sheen on everything that I thought could be metal. And this is just like the silver and the copper and the orange for rust effects. They're just like part of the base coat. So I'm just bringing this build up to a tabletop standard where it's playable. And then the actual painting that will take place later. I just want to fill a table as fast as possible. And then I can think about the colors that I want to use. But I really want this grimy, oily look with a lot of soot and a lot of rust. And I want a like a industrial mining town, maybe. Don't know what I'm going for yet. This could be a barrack, or this could be a comms facility, or it could be a mining office, or who knows. At least they have 5G antennas. So here's my terrain sauce. Terrain sauce is a wash, basically. It's made from water, pledge, medium, pouring medium, wood stain, ink, everything toxic that I could find. I threw it in a bottle, and because there's still a little bit of orange and a little bit of copper on my dry brush, that blends in beautiful with the oily texture of the wash, and it gives these super nice blended stains all over the model. I just slather it on. No need to be super tidy about this. I do take my time with the antenna though, because I don't want to break it. That's probably the least sturdy part of the entire build. So to get to this point took me roughly an hour. But having said that, I had my bits ready, yeah? So if you don't have your bits ready, it might take a little bit longer. So I'm letting this dry. While I'm letting this dry, I'm building a companion for it, an extra tile to sit next to it. Another 30 by 30 MDF sheet. Just hot gluing some mini stack, looks like granny grating, but it's a mini stack board I cut up to size to make quick walkway. The thing it's resting on is the IKEA footing for a cabinet. And here's a medicine tube on some Knex, more corrugated plastic. Yeah, stick it on the wall, makes it look interesting. Stick it on the roof, and this helps so much after I paint everything to just make it a little bit more authentic. There's another one of those things that keep toy cars in place in their cardboard box, and this is from a steam meal. I think it was chicken tandoori or something. Just take out the plastic that's in the microwave packaging at the bottom, stick it down with some super glue, and then seal it in with a little bit of hot glue so it can't come loose when I start painting and washing it, because sometimes the wash eats away at the super glue and then things fall apart. Just basic sealing. Now I took Acadian. I found some girder strips at the Gamma. It's like the Dutch Home Depot. And using a plint angle cutter, this is when you're doing your laminate on the floor. You cut the wooden plinths with it. I used that to cut the girder to size, and I glued the girder. Well, I thought that power glue was strong enough. Actually, the first girder came off a couple of times, so I opted to use hot glue on the second one, and eventually also sealing in the first one with the extra bit of hot glue. So I built these girders. As railings, just stick them to the mini stack board. You can easily use granny grating for this. And then for extra structural integrity, I connect the girders to the medicine pipe, and I double tap the edges. Another piece of railing on the front. Yeah, it didn't connect because of the IKEA footing, so I had to cut out a little recess. Did that with a clipper, nothing special. Some more glue on it. Sealing it outside, inside. So I wanted to add a little railing to the side too, then I thought, hey, what if I build an additional piece later? And then maybe want to create a walkway between those two pieces. So let's not get ceiling in this piece of Kinex. Found a lightsaber in the garden. The kids weren't using it anymore. And it had a nice detail. So I thought, why not use it? This is the gas canister of a confetti gun. I always rip those apart and keep the gas canisters. They make for wonderful greeblies. This from a Hot Wheels set, some traffic signs. Got the base up so it fit in the mini stack, and then I hot glued it in place. This is a loyalty card from the supermarket. It looks like a wonderful bulkhead or something. This is just a simple washer ring. I use washer rings to hide the beginnings of pipes. Makes it more mysterious where the pipe comes from. Like it creates the idea that there's something beneath the bulkhead. Don't like sticking pipes just straight to the floor. So I measure it up. First I always connect the top one, and then it's easy to fill the hole of the washer with some hot glue. So always stick on the top one first. Another washer. And just repeat the same thing here with this washer. And another piece of plastic washer, and then some more. Pipes. These pipes are just constructor straws. You get them for like €1 back at the Action. Action is all over Europe, so shouldn't have that hard of a time finding it. Another manure tank. I bought multiple barns and cranes, so they came with manure tanks. They look cool, like, I don't know, like Airco fluid or a deposit of promethium or whatever. Added a washer on top of the medicine pipe, and the vitamin pipe. And then I painted it and I washed it, dry brushed it. So this is what the partner piece looks like. I really enjoyed this build. If you see, like, the wash has dried on it and it really looks like spilled oil. So that's a little bit of a context shot. I'm not spoiling the entire build because I want to show you the table in a different video. But if you like this type of content, then a like, comment, and subscribe. Everybody who hits subscribe is my new favorite person in the world. So one day I want to turn this channel into a real terrain channel, and I want you guys to join the journey with me. So if you want to come on that journey, make sure you hit that button. Like always, what's up?